It looks like Apple might change their strategy when it comes to iPhone launches in 2021. The Samsung Galaxy S10 Lite just made an appearance in Samsung's website because they're hinting a launch, and Apple could be building a pair of AirPods for their upcoming flagship iPhones, it seems. I'm Jaime Rivera, and no, what you see here is no Photoshop. That sound is actually water. We're currently in Maui, Hawaii, Qualcomm Snapdragon Summit 2019. It's going to be awesome. This is Pocketnow Daily, powered by Qualcomm. Yes, we tried to get you some Cyber Monday deals. They're all on Pocketnow.com, by the way. The links are still there. Thing is, our flight was delayed, so obviously it took a while for us to be able to get you this video. Apologize for the wind noise or whatever. But anyways, we're here in Maui. There is a lot to expect from this tech summit. And well, let's begin with the predictions. Obviously, one of the things we're expecting is more developments in 5G. The rollout has been steady across the United States and abroad. So we are really curious as to see what the roadmap will be for 2020. We obviously also expect a new Snapdragon processor, since that's always the star of this show. But we hear that there might be other chips announced at this event. So stay tuned, as most of the announcements are happening tomorrow. Now, for those of you fans of the OnePlus 7T, back in September, we got two color variants, which was interesting since usually we get three, and out of the blue, there were just two. Apparently, the metallic gold variant was reportedly canceled before the phone went into mass production. Now, we don't know exactly why, but OnePlus designers just shared some images of this metallic gold variant, which means that we could expect a launch for this soon. OnePlus, I do want that color option. Thank you. Really appreciate it. Now let's move the spotlight over to Samsung, as obviously we're getting close to the Galaxy S11. There are a ton of rumors over what to expect, but we get some names that we should probably consider. Samsung just trademarked the name Bright Night. This component was rumored about a year ago, but it seems to be their new sensor for both phones and tablets. We don't know just yet what to expect when it comes to specifics for the cameras of the S11, but obviously if they're patenting the trademark right now, it could mean something, so stay tuned for that. Now this is rather interesting. Let's now move the spotlight still to Samsung, but also include Xiaomi and Apple, as apparently all these companies are considering something interesting for 2020. As you know, very few companies bundle earbuds in their packages, and Samsung changed things a bit with the Galaxy Fold, but apparently all these three companies are looking into bundling their true wireless earbuds for next year. Now, iPhones are already expensive as they are, so we wonder if AirPods or the inclusion of these would make the price tag more expensive, and I do hope that they're the pro variants, not the ones that I already hate, but we'll see. At least you get a pair of wireless earbuds and not the typical AirPods that everybody hates. And yes, how about if we also talk about the Samsung Galaxy S10 Lite? We still don't know what the purpose of this phone is. I mean, we're already so close to the S11, and yet more rumors continue to emerge. It seems that the S10 Lite just made an appearance in Samsung's French website. The model is the SMG770F. Which is the same one that was leaked in benchmarks and the FCC certification. The device is still weird, with specs that are even better than the regular S10, and in some cases, the S10 Plus. Now, there are rumors that it might be revealed as the Galaxy A51 instead, so we'll see what ends up happening. And finally, the most interesting news today have to do with the roadmap for iPhones and how Apple apparently is going to shake things up a bit when it comes to the launch plans for devices, but not necessarily in 2020. Analysts' predictions are that Apple will launch two phones in the first half of 2021 and two in the second half, when they usually get launched. Apple has experimented with spring launches before, but never for flagships. According to the analysts, this two-step release cycle would help smooth seasonality, as their sales are usually not good when it comes to the early stages of a year. It makes sense. I mean, we see OnePlus doing it with the OnePlus 7 and the OnePlus 7T, for example. The company has been doing it for years. It makes sense for Apple. I think that the last time they launched a flagship in June was the iPhone 4. Let us know in the comments down below. What do you think? Do you think that it makes sense for Apple to change the dates for their launch schedules? Because in my case, I mean, we've been seeing Galaxies do it as well. Galaxy S in spring, and then Galaxy Note in the fall. I think that that's the smarter way to do it, but we would love to know what you think in the comments down below. Yes, today's episode of the Pocketnow Daily is powered by Qualcomm. The company has proven its leadership in laying the foundation for 5G for years. To date, 5G has been deployed in more than 20 countries by more than 40 operators around the world, which is quite a record if you compare previous technology rollouts. Only devices powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon processors and modems are currently capable of giving you the full 5G experience with both sub-6 and millimeter wave. Stay tuned, as obviously this Snapdragon Summit will lay the foundation for everything we should expect in 2020 and probably the future as well. Follow the link in the description to learn more about Qualcomm's success in 5G. Friends, again, if you want to get the news earlier, follow us on Pocketnow.com and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. Also, follow us on social medias. Our extended coverage happens on Instagram, and follow me on my personal handles to see me play around in Hawaii. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I'm Jaime Rivera. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.